You join me for a little winter installment to take a peek into the weapons locker. One tactic that our John Caffey has advocated for many years now is what we came to call gridline bombing. Last week, the grid system in Eve changed forever. The general nature of grids is beyond the scope of a small video such as this one, and if you're not familiar with the grid concept, you'll need to do research elsewhere. You can essentially think of them as areas of space, usually a few hundred kilometers across, in which the Eve action takes place. It's the space that covers the actual objects on screen that are rendered by your PC and appear in your overview. Obviously, given that the grid system is what makes something appear, it's inevitable that Eve players would also use it to make things disappear, and so-called grid foo was a major tactical aspect of the Great War around 2006, the days when the likes of Band of Brothers battled with Goon Swarm and Red Alliance. Back then, sniping battleships were a tool of choice, and stretching and shaping the grid to suit engagement ranges and opportunities were a key factor of grid foo. Other situations might have involved dancing back and forth over a grid line to make a fleet disappear to the hostiles between volleys. Those interested in that era might do well to read Goonswarm's manual about grid foo, which is widely available online. The grid line bombing concept is a little different. Bombing has been used in conjunction with grids before, such as to manipulate a grid to hide bombers and then hit a fleet waiting at zero on a gate. However, this is different again. The first part is the bubble. If you initiate warp to a grid that has an interdiction bubble in your path, as you might expect, you'll hit the bubble's edge. However, if the grid line intersects the bubble edge, then your ship still hits the edge of the bubble, even though this means you arrive on an entirely different grid to your intended destination. What's more, because your PC only renders objects on grid, and the bubble's origin began on another grid, you see no bubble. Even though you warped to a gate, you arrive in what seems to be an empty spot in space. So, you click again to warp to the gate, but, of course, even though it's not being rendered, there is in fact an invisible bubble intersecting your warp path, and you get an error message informing you that you can't warp. In addition to that, many of the ships caught are likely to be within the bubble radius, and would have to turn around and fly back the other way out of the bubble that they can't see, in order to escape. The next part are the bombs. Bombs are objects, and can cross grids, but bomb damage cannot. Thus, bombs can be fired at the helpless ship from the grid containing the bubble's origin, and thus leave it unable to see the bombers, just as it cannot see the bubble. More importantly, since bomb damage does not traverse a grid, large numbers of staggered bombs can be fired without those that are exploding on the destination grid destroying those that are still in flight. And so, to the helpless ship who is trapped by the invisible bubble and cannot warp, bombs appear from nowhere, and these bombs are mostly immune to their own damage, and so vastly more can be fired without the requirement of a vector bombing or other methods to prevent them destroying each other in flight. Of course, with the event of the much larger grids in December 2015, much greater grid manipulation would be required to bring the grid edge to intersect a pipe bomb style bubble. Therefore, it seemed fitting to say goodbye in style. Given that our remaining active forces are deployed in the Far East, John suggested farming out the operation to someone unorthodox, like Hoover Inc. Now, Rick Hoover is a man of Herculean stature, but I've seen him pilot an airship in Air Buccaneers, and so I decided it might be best to keep our own hands on our sticks. And so, late on the night of the last day of the grid system, a mid-sized battlecruiser fleet was found, who in turn found themselves in warp to a bubble on a grid they had no intention of going to. Satisfyingly, the bombs appear from nowhere, and although firing with more than a full squad of bombers, the bombs did not destroy each other. To their credit, the Goon Swarm fleet did reverse engineer what had happened, and in a rather macabre show of good manners, one of their members collected the 2 dozen or so corpses and presented them to us. And then, a few hours later, the databases updated, the servers were patched, an atomic clock somewhere ticked over, and grids in Eve changed forever. The beginning and the end. Well, mostly.